Got it. No, I was so I've had this friend, Harold Lee, and the real Harold.
Oh wow!
Since I was in middle school, when I lived in Pittsburgh, and then we reunited when we were in college at Penn, and then American Pie comes out, and Harold doesn't exactly look like John Cho, but he looked enough like John Cho to people in Philadelphia who just saw American Pie. So every time we go out to bars and stuff, we'd hear people would you'd hear MILF, and you'd hear people people would go over to him, genuinely thinking that he was the guy in American Pie, like and it was and it didn't happen like once or twice, it happened routinely every time we went out. So
it just sounds like racism is what I'm hearing.
It was part racism but part like reality, but it was one of the part, you know, just, you know, it was all it was honest and coming from a good place from these people. That's and when Hayden and I started writing, you know, before Harold and Kumar, we had written some other scripts, and we always had characters, Harold and Kumar, as the side characters. Like the main characters were, you know, like more like, you know, it would be like Ben and Evan instead of John and Hayden, that kind of thing. And then their best friends would be Harold and Kumar, because a lot of our friends were Asian and Indian guys, and we had a friend named Harold. So it was one of those things that, like, you know, we always wrote them as side characters, but then, and John, and because we loved John so much in American Pie, then we watched Off Center, and we loved Eddie K. Thomas also.
Yeah.
And it was like, so we watched Off Center, and we're like, John Cho's hilarious. Like he's like the Kramer of this show. He's so good. And we're like, this guy could carry a movie. So it gave us the confidence to write Harold and Kumar Go to White Castle.
No, I honestly had such a good feeling for you guys just based on that. And so did a lot of people I worked with at that time, because I was really glad that you, I was so happy people saw that for him, and God knows he doesn't need our help right now in his career. But you know, at the time, I want this guy should be a bigger star. And and I also just deeply what I love. So, well, a couple of things. I just now fanboy over this real quick in the last at the end of this podcast. But you perfectly captured the difficulty of getting anything done when you're high. Like that everything feels like a Herculean effort. And just like, I really do remember being like, it was up at Syracuse, but like there was a hamburger truck that was just across campus, and it was there till 3 a.m. And it was just like, and just a half hour of deliberating, how are we gonna get it? And the idea of you taking that and turning it into like almost a, the journey of the hero, a Star Wars journey of the hero, where you're accomplishing all of that stuff, is so great.